Indic series after a short gap. And this gap is essentially given by JK sir and Ramaraj sir to build our Indic muscles and prepare them for the next onslaught of Indic sessions. So just to begin with, a few announcements. So as many members and non-members would be aware, we are having our expert circle online for answering all your entrepreneurial questions. So if you have any questions pertaining to any field of entrepreneurship, any domain, we have our experts. Just put in your question on the expert circle platform on the website and we'll get them answered. Also, the Mentor Connect has now been completely made online. So you can actually go and see which mentor you want to choose, their profile. It's completely available all on the website. You can make a calculation based on that. And the turnaround time has also been shortened considerably. The third announcement is the Thai Global Summit is happening in Mumbai on the 20th. So I would request entrepreneurs who are interested to register for the same. And the last and the most important announcement, the next Indic session, session 3, is on the 9th of March. So request you all to Indic fans to register as early as possible. And moving on to the introductions, the speakers are very synonymous with us, so but it's my duty to introduce them. So firstly, I would like to introduce Mr. R. Ramaraj. He is currently a senior advisor at Eliver Equity. He is also the co-founder of reputed organizations like SIPI and the Coaching Foundation of India, which is one of the leading CEO coaching foundations. Next, I would like to introduce Mr. J. Krishnan. Mr. J. Krishnan, fondly known as JK, is an alumnus of IIT and IIM. He was also an advisor to SIPI from the year 97 to 2002. And one of the unique achievements is he was also the CEO of Deccan Chargers Cricket Team in the year 2008. He is currently promoting his own venture, Unimity Solutions. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
Akshay.
Good evening.
Sir.
How many of you, I see some regulars here, but how many of you are attending the Indic series for the first time? I've seen you. Okay. How many first time?
Many.
Oh, that's quite. We like it that it's getting the interest of some more people. So what we do? This audio is pretty high.
You want to move that? It's
put it down.
Yeah. No, it's echoing.
Is it? Echoing. Oh, a little loud. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah, okay? Yeah. So I'm going to give you very briefly some inputs on what we have covered so far. This is our second series. So the first series, we are now moving on to the Indic Gym that we have acquired, which is already available. And the wealth of knowledge available through our ancient literature, through many ages, and things that have been passed on, things that have been forgotten, things that are useful, and things that are useful for us who are engaged in corporate life for performance. So we covered many aspects of what they are and how to make sure those important wisdom which we can use for ourselves in our lives for performance. It's about giving up and it's about all those things that go with our thoughts that it is Indian and Vedic. Second, we also have a feeling it's about religion, it's about gods and goddesses, it's about rituals, it's about worship, it's about prayer. So I first want to say it's about none of those. That this Indic Way and therefore Indic Gym is all about what aspects of that knowledge or wisdom is useful for us in performance in life, which means in acquiring wealth, in enjoyment, in all other aspects that we all know in our lives. But how done? Under what particular principles? So the Indic Way covered a lot of those aspects. And in the Indic Way, one of the most important things that we did was while very clearly we are going after acquiring all that wisdom and knowledge for performance in life, we first defined what was life, what does life consist of, and therefore if we need to be successful in life, what particular strengths do we need to build, and what come in the way of us achieving something, we call them disturbances, and all these disturbances are happening here. So the Indic way very clearly identified that the wisdom and the knowledge that resides in the ages and that we shared with the audience at different sessions was all about understanding how to make sure that the energies that we have and the strengths that we have are built towards achieving success, performance in life. Clear about the objectives? So therefore, I'm again repeating, it is not about renunciation, it is not about sannyas, it is not about giving up, but it's about active engagement with life. Having said that, a lot of people, when we finished the Indic way, they did say, hey, you know, we've definitely got an exposure to what is important and how to approach life, but it will be useful if we also start to understand how to do the different things that you said. So you said we come up with the Indic Gym, and this is where the exercises are going to happen for us to build what we call the Indic muscles. And the Indic muscles to be built in the Indic Gym so that these Indic muscles help us in the performance in life. Which is why we came up with the series called the Indic Gym. Ram, can you intro remarks?
Good evening. So, one of the challenges is that all our education is now benchmarked against the West. And if it is not coming from the West, we have a tendency to not just ignore it, but there is a mental block to accept. And this has happened because 200 years ago, a guy called Lord Macaulay, he was Macaulay at that time, not yet Lord, visited India length and breadth as East India Company and went back and said in the UK Parliament that this is a dynamic, peaceful, rich country. There is no way we can take over this country unless you break with the tradition they have. Let them learn English. Moment they learn English, they will look down on those who don't know English. Get them westernized. They will forget and they will be a fisher, divide and rule. And that is why he was sent back as Governor General, became Lord Macaulay, and very successfully brought that about. And so we may survive for 200 plus years. Therefore, we all have this thing, including me. When I started reading about this, my mother told me, Inda Vaisla Thevaya, what is your hurry when you are 30 to go look at all this? Why don't you wait till you are 60 when it doesn't mean anything as to how to live life? The art and skill of living life dynamically. All of us are looking to acquire and enjoy. Most of our life, we are acquiring and having heart attacks, so that by the time we have all of that, somebody else is there to enjoy and not us. Is there a way that we can both have fun and be wealthy? So it's not escape, as JK said, it's a question of how can we acquire and enjoy and be dynamic in this. So that's really what we are trying to do. So we said all this and people said, tell us how. And so we said, let's take a few of those weakening areas and see if we can strengthen that. One other thing that we emphasize, which we will talk about, is that we act, body acts based on two instruments. One is called the mind, manas, the other is called buddhi, the intellect. Most of us are not aware that we have something called the intellect. We are all aware of intelligence. Intelligence is something we acquire in school, in college, in libraries, in reading, in education. I have learned chemical engineering. I don't know anything about it now, but I did learn chemical engineering. So that is an intelligence that I acquired about chemical engineering to make a living. It is not an equipment. It is something that has helped me do something better. But your decision to come here this evening is driven by one of two things. Either the mind, which tells you, I'm curious, maybe I want to hear, or some friend tried to hear. So that is one way. Two, intellect, which says, this may be something that I want to go and figure out. It sounds new. Let me go. Listen. I may reject it at the end. But using that discriminatory ability, the choice, exercising that is the intellect. One of the things nobody has taught us is how to strengthen that intellect, the ability to manage our choices. Every moment we are dealing with choices. How do we choose one action over another? How do we avoid at the end of the day saying, oh shucks, I wish I didn't say that. Oh shucks, I wish I didn't do that. Looking back and saying, oh God, I wish my brains were available at that time. Why didn't I think of it at that moment? That ability to do that is the intellect. And so we touched upon this as one of the key things we need to strengthen. We talk about how to strengthen that intellect, which is really the governor, the driver of quality action. So these were broadly what we did, taking up some things to see how.
This session is about letting go anger and fear. We want to deep dive into this after a short thing about what we covered in the earlier session. And like Ram said, the rest of the programs are all about understanding many powers that we have and trying to figure out how to channelize these. So in all of these, we will address two things. We call them rattles and disturbances. What causes rattle? What causes disturbance in the human system? We took an example in the earlier session where we spoke of the automobile, understood the automobile, and why the automobile has rattles. How do you make sure that is fixed? What gets you a smooth ride on the road of life? And took the same parallel and say, what causes disturbances in us? What are those disturbances? How do you make sure that those rattles and disturbances do not occur? And if they occur, how do you manage or overcome? All these are the things that we covered. And so we are getting now into saying, hey, how do I do it? So one of the things is reigning in the mind towards equanimity, and this is where it empowers us towards performance. We're going to understand that. And like Ram said, building the intellect, and how we build this is an entire session which is devoted to that. And using all these muscles, how do we then go after to make sure that we are able to perform and achieve in life? Build Indic muscles. Clearly we said it's for performance in life. So deal with ups and downs in events, situations, and relationships. We have done a lot of this in earlier sessions, so I'm not spending time now. But it's all about dealing with ups and downs in life, whether it's in an event, situation, or relationship. Reducing the rattles and disturbances, this is what I shared with you. We will now, you know, identify what are these rattles and disturbances, and then how we make sure we are able to reduce or overcome. Handle them with equanimity. Achieve control and focus. Who is in control? Am I in control, or is my mind taking me all over the place? And I, superior to the mind, have lost control and just going with wherever mind is taking me. So, achieving control and focus towards performance and happiness. This is why we need to build the Indic muscles. And what are these muscles? What are these muscles to build? They want to get into this. Acceptance. It's a muscle, it's an approach, it's a thing which we're going to see even as we get into this session. Action. Everything in life is about action. Action is in our hands. Action actually is the only thing that we can do. Results are not in our hands. We may go after many objectives, we may go after different things, but all we can do at any point of time, Ram keeps referring to it as to say the quality of action. It is the quality of action, and therefore that is a muscle. being non-judgmental is an extremely important thing in building relationships. So we're going to see that. Equanimity, we already covered. Intellect, we already covered. And there is a superior person in me. And we need to understand that if I can operate from the superior level in me, I have the ability to do all this so that I can go after performance in life. Then what do I do? Maybe if I had deodorant, perfume, I can only mask. See, please understand, deodorant and perfume, I can only mask.
Not eliminate.
Not eliminate. Absolutely. Not eliminate. Absolutely. So just get this in our minds, saying certain things I can use neither reduces nor eliminates but masks.
Same thing with your
glasses
also.
Sure.
Sure. He's there. Yeah. This smell.
Yes.
The bad odor is being overtaken by a costly perfume.
Absolutely.
You put.
Absolutely.
As the day goes,
absolutely.
This comes back.
Absolutely. So we are going to use these parallels just to know that, hey, for us to reduce anything, the opposite force needs to be brought in. If I need to reduce darkness, if I need to remove darkness, I have to bring light. Okay. If I have to reduce or remove ignorance, what? Knowledge. No,
knowledge.
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 So, keep this in our minds to say, when we therefore go into anger or envy or jealousy or fear or any one of the emotions, if I need to reduce or eliminate, the opposite force needs to be brought in. This is a fundamental principle in our ancient system, that building happens through addition, development of opposites. Building happens through reduction, removal. Ram has this favorite thing called shampooing the insides. He's actually patented a technology, he's going to bring it into the market, that every morning, after you brush your teeth, he's got this great instrument, very small one, you put it through your nose and clean the insides of the mind. Every morning. All the muck inside the mind will vanish, and then that's it. As much as, therefore, brush your teeth, you can shampoo the insides of the mind. So, is there some way shampooing the insides is the thing which we need to look at? Same thing, born from ore, removal of impurities. All of this is happening through reduction of different things. So, just keep this in mind that these are the same parallels. What is valid for the physical body is valid for the mental realm in which we are operating. So this is the other thing. Muscles are in the nature of power generators, stabilizers and shock absorbers. The earlier thing, we took the example, therefore, we all drive an automobile. What is a pleasurable ride? Define. What is a pleasurable ride?
No traffic in the road.
No, pleasurable ride. Whether there is traffic.
No bumps.
Whether there are bumps. Pleasurable ride. You are not changing the road conditions. The pleasurable ride is whether there are bumps, there are potholes, there are anything, the shock absorbers in the system, they take it so that you don't feel anything. Why therefore do you see Mercedes, Benz, Rolls Royce, etc., etc.? It will take the ups and downs of the road, the potholes and the bumps and all the speed breakers and traffic, etc., etc. You inside have no discomfort. A pleasurable ride. Pleasurable ride are through power generators, stabilizers, shock absorbers that need to be part of the system. We're just placing all this so that you get these comparisons in mind when we go into dealing with anger and fear and envy and other things. This fragrance versus perfume, this also we mentioned last time, and therefore what anybody wants to take it? What is the difference between fragrance and perfume? Anybody? Is there a difference at all? Fragrance and perfume. Take a guess. Anybody.
Fragrance is natural.
Fragrance is natural. Very nice.
Perfume is
artificial. Very nice. So, we say a flower has fragrance. A flower has fragrance, not perfume. You may make perfume from those flowers later on. So, you are absolutely right. Fragrance is part of the system. Perfume is artificial. So when we move towards, we call, what is the difference between a fragrant personality and a perfumed personality? You understand? We don't want to build a perfumed personality, which goes away by the evening. You understand? You are perfectly right. Therefore, by as the course of the day, perfume has vanished and the true personality surfaces. Whereas the fragrant personality is the one we are driving towards, that this fragrant personality is in control. In all engagements, the fragrant personality comes across.
Goes astray.
Absolutely. And therefore, completely, no disturbances as far as this is concerned.
Just digressing slightly, but to bring this up. One of the things we all do in our companies is to get people to work, to motivate them. What is the one thing we try to do? I want to motivate my sales guys. I want them to do something. What is the first thing that comes to our mind? What do we do?
Incentives.
Yes. Correct? Isn't that perfect?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So the question is, in the good old days, they said work is worship. We spend, I don't know, 12 hours maybe at work. And we need incentives. Therefore, we look forward to Friday evenings in our own business. So whether you are coming because of an initiative or because of an incentive, is it an external motivation or is it from within? Depends on your reaction to a Monday morning. If your Monday morning means, oh God, you may want to do a shampooing of your visa to find out what motivates you to come to work. And that is what we are trying to see, how to get more and more people driven from some motivation or purpose rather than the cash. We've all learned diminishing returns, law. So if you want me to do some work, I give you 10 rupees. Now to do the same work after 3 months, you have to give me 20 rupees. So, it's a never-ending cycle. So how do you transform to looking forward to a Monday morning? The day you do that, the break, it's coming from within. And that's really the asset test. How much is coming from within and how much are you motivated by things outside? So initiative versus incentive is another way.
So let's get to this session. Do we get angry? How many people here do not get angry at all? No, zero anger. How many of us get angry?
One of my colleagues is here. See, why is this fellow talking about letting go anger? I've never seen him not angry. So he's come just to see the difference over 15 years. So that's why he's here.
No, what you don't know is whether he still gets angry but he masks it and perfumes it, or whether that we don't know. So do we get angry?
Yes.
How often? Anybody? Once a day? Once a week, every day, youngsters I want, every day,
yes.
Every occasion.
Yes.
Hey, why is this not hot? Why is this cold? Yes, you know, can you something? Every day, how many of you every day, something or other? And I want to give you a gradation. I figured out that though we are saying anger, it can be irritation, anger, rage. In a scale, all of that are of the same thing. Some order, some anger in terms of some surface. So how often? Pretty frequent, okay? Next is how intense. How intense? You know why I put this Richter scale? I don't know whether you all know that the Richter scale is how earthquakes are measured. No, more important. It's a logarithmic scale. Which means if there is Richter of that magnitude of 5, the magnitude of 6 is 10 times as intense as the magnitude of 5. The magnitude of 7 is 10 times as intense as 6. And 30 times as much energy in each of those. So same thing, when it moves from irritation to anger to rage, it's all logarithmic in terms of how quickly we lose our control. So how intense? How intense? I want to know. I want to very clearly, like you said, expectation versus reality. I want to give an example if I can. So, market is at the 100 rupees, it's 50 rupees. Negative side. I was in good health. Suddenly they diagnosed that I have some BP which I need to take care of. Unexpected things that I did not anticipate. That is, expectation versus reality is a gap. I was at zero. When an unexpected event happens, it is on the negative side of the graph. Therefore, there is a gap because I was thinking everything is okay. There is something else happening. The unexpected event is the same in terms of creating the gap between the reality and the expectation or non-expectation. All of these are the source for anger, and therefore this is a very valid comment to say expectation versus reality causes anger. No? With who do we get angry? Anybody wants to take a guess?
Typically close. Someone who is close to us.
Someone who is close to us. That is also true.
She said to us.
Yeah. Absolutely. Herself too. Sometimes I found same situation, but I won't get angry with him in that same situation, but I get angry with him. Because he's my favorite. So anger especially arises because we bracket people automatically. People we like, we don't like that much.
The function of your relationship.
Sometimes we instantaneously take one little dislike. Our partner is dead, our partner is dead. Our partner is dead. Very powerful. In the basis of our own, you have a cooling glass, another problem. The all sorts of things, we come up with things which are, so I'll come to judgment later, but therefore likes and dislikes is another aspect which creates anger. Come, this is what you want.
So, why should we even be spending so much time on anger? What happens to us if we get angry? So what? So what?
Ability to think rationally or it just freezes sometimes the mind doesn't we're not able to think sensibly, think and action sensibly.
Is that true?
Yes.
Anger is also lack of maturity.
Immature.
Lack of maturity.
Lack of
maturity.
Spoils the mood. Spoils the behavior.
Yes.
Your anger is not going to change in behavior unless you want to change in behavior.
Right action. What interferes in the quality of our action? Emotions that can come in the way of our quality of action at the time we want to act. Which means, rest of the day we are saying, oh God, why did I behave like this? I shouldn't have said this. I shouldn't have done that. And for everything, we blame an outside factor for our anger. Somebody crossed the road. In Chennai, if an auto rickshaw or a bike doesn't cut me, then I have to pinch myself saying, am I in Chennai or have I gone to the UK or some other place? So, if I am in Chennai and I am driving, the only thing I look at is 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes before I lose my cool. Can I improve that and make it 15 minutes? So it is expected that when you are in Chennai and driving in this traffic, some fellow is going to try and see if he can go past your bumper without hitting. So, but it's an external factor. It's still a rattle and angry. And then we talk about road rage. In Gurgaon, they pull out a gun and maybe come after you. So then they have lost the control. So the whole idea of how should we stay objective
But I won't get angry with him in that same situation, but I'll get angry with him. But he's my favorite. So, anger especially arises, so we bracket people automatically. People we like, we don't like that much.
Function of your relationship.
No, no, no. We, sometimes we instantaneously take one little dislike. அவங்களை பார்த்ததே கிடையாது, அவங்களோட படிக்கிறதே கிடையாது, ஆனால் பார்த்தோம் இது பார்த்துக்கோம். எந்த பேசிஸ் சொல்றோம், இந்த கூலிங் கிளாஸ் தலையில் போட்டு ஆல் சார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் வி கம் அப் வித் திங்ஸ் விச் ஆர் கம் டு ஜட்மெண்ட் லேட்டர். பட் தேர்ஃபோர் லைக்ஸ் அண்ட் டிஸ்லைக்ஸ் இஸ் அதர் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் விச் கிரியேட்ஸ்
anger. So, lack of maturity.
Lack of
maturity.
Lack of
maturity.
Spoils the mood, spoils that day or 2 hours or 3 hours, it spoils. Yes.
See, your anger is not going to change in behavior unless he wants to change his behavior.
Yeah, that's his problem.
I don't know, but you are honestly getting angry on somebody. Why are you going to consistently come to office at 10:30? You will say come at 9:30. He will come only at 10:30. No point in getting angry. It's only our health system will go for a task.
Alvin, is that?
Changes the outcome.
Changes the outcome.
Whatever is going to happen, I don't think straight and things go wrong.
Which is, so, yeah, correct.
The consequences, that we face due to our anger, and that then we have to be ready. It is the way our scheme.
Is it you not be also
Please, please.
Anger is like smoking.
It's like smoking.
No, we know that it injures the health. We know that it is bad. But still, it has become an habit.
Not able to let it go.
It's become a habit, like, you know.
See, the whole Indic way is how to have right action.
Right? I'll summarize. We get angry because of all people outside of us, all events outside of us. We left it with the thought, who holds the remote to my anger. That is, I'm now going to summarize that to say, therefore, oh, you said, you didn't say, you did, you didn't do, should have, oh, it did, it didn't, it should have, all these things, right? That's what we said, all these things are the ones which are called anger. If I change this, and you say, okay, he said, okay, she didn't say. Okay, you did. Okay, didn't do. Okay, should have. Okay, should have. Okay, 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 okay. Accept. Change all okay. Watch the anger or hurt disappear. This is our first muscle. This is the first Indic muscle which we are saying is so important for us to develop, for us to let go of anger. And I want to bring back another thing. Ram and I were discussing this on the way here to say, when we are referring to let go of anger, we are referring to it in two levels of things. One, letting go is to let go so that it no more surfaces in me. Romba kashtam. Very difficult. Even in our own, itihasas and the Puranas and all that we know, all the sages and all the rishis had anger with them. There is Vishwamitra, there is Durvasa, all sorts of Lord Shiva. Anger is part of people. So it's not about no anger. And emotions will surface in us. Emotions are continuously surfacing. We don't need to worry about the fact that emotions are surfacing. So when we're talking of letting go of anger, we are not referring to letting go of anger where it no more arises in me. That letting go is one level of letting go. A very high ideal, if we can reach there, fantastic. But the other letting go is what I said. When I walked in, somebody spilled coffee on my shirt. Can I let go of this anger in 2 minutes, 1 minute, 10 seconds? So this letting go is about the duration and intensity and the frequency. So we are referring to saying, please look at letting go anger in the sense that, hey, even if it is arising, can I quickly let it go?
How many of you have done a cardiac stress test?
Yeah.
Mental? Yeah. What does the doctor check?
The
How soon do you come back to your normal pulse? That is more important than the time it took for you to double your pulse rate.
Yeah.
How quickly can you recover is a measure of your health. So it is not just getting angry, but how quickly do you come back to normal? It is another test or a check on health.
So we want to say, think about this. Think about this. The sooner we can accept that this event has happened, she said it, he didn't say it, or he did, she didn't do, it happened, it didn't happen. The quicker we accept saying that is what it is, you will find anger disappears.
So how do you come to that answer?
Huh?
How?
Just a thought on this part. Trying to accept things and
move on. It's not easy.
The thing is, if you had a very intense day, right from morning, rolling session, back to back, and somebody passed me a comment, and then it just ticks you off. Oh, definitely it can't be your mind is like an electric wire, it's like buzzing, and then suddenly things ticks off. But if you had a very calm and a normal day, which is not a very crazy day, then I think you will have the mental thing, okay, that's fine, let's see what can happen.
So you're saying it's also a thing of your own level of agitation or your own level of stress at that particular point in time.
To accept it.
That if you are stress free, it's easy to accept. But if you are stressed, maybe it's difficult to accept.
Again, you may want to think about it. Say, how did it become a hectic day?
Yeah.
My boss drove me nuts. Okay, my supplier drove me nuts. Everybody else drove me nuts. I'm perfectly sane.
Yeah.
Okay. All the others are driving me nuts. So, what is it that makes it a hectic day? What makes Monday morning miserable? It's another day. Tuesday is okay. Monday morning, the anticipation of going to work comes every 7 days, unfortunately. What drives us nuts on that morning is again external. So, you may want to just think about that. As to what made it a hectic.
So I'm doing this from a entrepreneurial mind.
Maybe we just spend 10 minutes on fear as we end up the session. This is part of our Indic thinking. To say, what could be four approaches that we can take if there's a situation which causes anger or hurt? First, they said, therefore, direct communication or discussion. Actually go and see if you can talk to the person concerned where the anger was, and if that is possible, and if you can do it in a measured, calm manner, that can be one way where this anger or hurt situation can be handled.
So there's a story in WhatsApp that's been going around about some kid who was coming to work or coming to school late, and class teacher got angry, then went up to principal. Finally, the class teacher decided to go and see the boy and talk to his parents maybe. That's when he realized that this kid has to earn his living and was delivering newspapers, milk, etc. and then coming to school and then found. You would have seen that, right? I think going around a bit. Therefore, this communication and discussion, you may understand, root cause, like your guy coming at 10:30.
Next, they say, sharing or consultation. So, I may not be able to go to Ramaraj and actually say, hey, what, like, because I'm still worried whether I will be able to present myself correctly or not. I don't do that. I talk to my friend and say, hey, this is what happened here. Ram said this. Whatever. When I share or consult, there is an expression of my true feelings, and that itself brings down my own temperature or my own thing, because that expression itself is one outlet for something to happen, and therefore they talk of, if you are not able to directly communicate or discuss, sharing is also a good way for you to let go. I want to keep coming back to saying the whole thing is about letting go of that anger or that hurt in that episode. we are still not addressing letting go anger itself in totality. That can happen over a period of time. But even in that episode, therefore, this can make sure either the intensity or the duration for which it is there is in some way handled. There's another lovely thing which our people talk, which is called Pratipaksha Bhavana, which means the counter thinking. The third aspect is called neutralization, which we spoke of. We spoke of those methods where one of the things is therefore, I think of all pleasant things. I think of good things that happened. I think of other aspects which can make sure either this anger or hurt is reduced through bringing in counter thinking to neutralize this particular anger which is happening. All of these are important. Please understand that all of this is therefore letting go in the quickest possible time for me to regain my composure, my equanimity, my status quo in terms of the disturbance that is currently happening in me and how to make sure that that disturbance is now removed from my system.
Can you just elaborate a little bit on this?
I'm going to cover something, then I want to. The fourth aspect, I'm using the word deposit very clearly. In a lot of our things also there are a lot of people who believe in prayer, in worship. They all have their own personal deities to whom they may place it there and say, hey, I'm leaving it with you. Find me an answer. Find me a solution. That is, the letting go is also happening because you think you have placed it with a mentor, coach, a higher authority, and it's called dilution. It dilutes, therefore, what you're carrying as a heavy load in yourself, and you think you're going to get something because there's somebody more knowledgeable, more an authority, whom you have roped in to say, help me out in some form. All these four are definite strategies which work towards what it is, but the primary thing is still acceptance. The moment you accept, a lot of things dissipate. If it's still there, any one of these, a combination of these, are bound to make sure that as quickly as possible, we are letting go of that anger or hurt. I don't want to take these stories now, it will take a long time, but we have three stories, we'll try and circulate them. About this alone I will say because it is very similar to yours. There was this plumber who visited this gentleman to look after something that needs to be done in his house. When he came there, he shared with him, hey, my car is broken down. I've had a very bad day, my tool is not working, my bank is calling and asking me to repay my loan. I have all sorts of issues which are chasing me today. He shared those with him, but he completes his work. When he completes his work, then the customer says, since your car is broken down, I'll drop you back at home. So he drops him back at home. During the drive, he's able to make out that he's completely loaded with all his worries and his, you know, depressing day full of challenges, nothing working out for him. So they reach home and he says, hey, why don't you come and meet my family? You come all the way, at least have a cup of coffee with us. So they get out of the car. Before he enters the house, he touches a tree which is in front of his house, closes his eyes for a minute or so, enters the house, and he's a completely changed man. Hi, honey! Hi, kids! How was your day? What's happening? And you all have a great day. He's a completely changed person. None of the things which this person, this customer saw as the guy who was, is the guy now in the house. So he takes him aside and says, hey, what is this? What is the sudden transformation? What did you do? You know that tree there? That is my worry. When I come home, I first know that none of my problems, none of the things that have happened for me in work or office belongs at home. I park them there overnight. Next day morning, I go there to pick up. I don't find as many as I hung the previous day. An approach which when you said, therefore, there's so much of this. All of these are methods. It's basically then saying in our own minds, we are separating out and we're saying, I don't carry this there. I don't carry this with that person with whom I'm interacting. All this yelling, I don't carry forward and now yell at my salesman. It's only a method which works in our mind. These are all good strategies for us to look at to handle time.
So, you know, you keep saying accept. How to accept?
How do you accept? The starting point of acceptance is an assessment of the situation or the person. Do we assess? I have this thing that I keep talking about. In animals, and I said this I think in the earlier session, in animals, we know a cobra. We know how to behave with a cobra. We will not behave with a cat and a cobra the same way. There's a big, we know how to deal with cats and cobras and tigers. What we don't know is that in the human race, that uniformity is not there. When I look at somebody, I don't know if there's a cat or a tiger or a cobra. How do I assess so that my behavior with that person, once I assess this person is a tiger, then my behavior is different than if I have assessed that this person is a cat. So how starting point is we don't assess people. We assume they are like what we want them to be. So then we are disappointed. Our starting point is assess a situation. My flight is delayed. That is a reality. I have assessed. Now what do I do? That is the next. But if I haven't assessed it, if I am in Chennai and I am driving, it is definitely going to be chaotic. And if I expect it to be any other place, how can the bike in Chennai not want to try his luck going between my car and the next? So assessment is the starting point of our ability to assess. If we don't assess, then expectation and reality mismatch is completely all the time. And getting angry with ourselves is part of wrong assessment.
The
power of patience and acceptance we have already covered. Taking a deep breath, that's what Ram wanted to share, so that he's already done. It's all about, therefore, letting go of anger to reduce either its frequency or intensity or duration in which we want to do. We're going to pause here. We're not going to take up fear, because that will need another half an hour to do it. We can combine it with in our next session. We pause here and take stock in terms of some prescriptions and approaches for us to let go of anger. Most important is that acceptance, which we will rephrase as an acknowledgement, as to understand the reality, as Ram said. That itself is the first. If you stay in reality, very quickly your mind's agitation is under control. You can then move to what do I need to do now, next, in order to do something. But the disturbance in the mind will start to settle down. So we think that's one of the most things, watching the mind and its thoughts. Anger is arising. Is the first thing. Like Ram said, whether it is taking those, you know, look, watching your breath or watching your mind, it is to even first say, hey, anger is arising in me. When I know anger is arising in me, mind has a great capacity. Mind is the shampoo for the mind. Mind has this great ability to control the mind, whether it is the intellect or there is anything still part of this system. When I, hey, anger is arising in me, I can then do something about it, whether I will continue in that direction and pursue those thoughts, or I will look at, hey, okay, whatever is up to me, I have that choice to say I pursue in that direction and allow this to become bigger and bigger, or I quickly want to move to letting it go. So that is the first. And we spoke of therefore the four strategies for letting go of anger, and we'll stop here and we will take some questions before we end the session.